And then when you oof. Oof, indeed. All right. Oh, yeah. Not even worth selling. Let's see. Yeah. I remember I actually had to, like, go to the load character option in the main menu and pick that character again from the list of characters I'd made. And if I could just get that site 3 for this thing, I'd have a good medium in terms of zoom range. Nope. Oh, he has a thunderstorm. Still, would you? Oh, there you are. Whoops. Forgot to re-equip my transfusion. Might as well do that. Gotcha. Come. Come on. Are y'all stuck under... Wow. Idiots. That was a fail. I didn't want to pick up that SMG without looking at it first. Christ. Oh god, that's not even worth selling. I got a ton of stuff to sell. Sell that. That's gone in 30. And I think this'll end up getting obsolete pretty soon here. Oh boy. You done? Goddamn daddy long legs from hell, I swear. Little people, big experiments. All right. Gotcha. Where is this guy? Oh. Hi, guys. Bye, guys. No, 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 no. Didn't jump in time. All right, let's try that again. Didn't make a difference anyway. All right. No. No. And there's one weapon chest left in this area. Well, in this particular corner of the map. Do you always do every mission when you play this? Not always, but often. Bit of a completionist, I guess you could say. These drifters respawn often. Seemed like it, that's why I asked. Yeah, no worries. But usually, at least in the first playthrough, why not the second? Well, I usually do it in the second playthrough as well, but with some exceptions. Like the really annoying missions I'm less likely to do. Oh, that's worth selling. So, like, certain ones, yeah, I can understand that. Yeah, it's... well... bit of a completionist streak, and... yeah, just wanting to explore the map at a pace I'm comfortable with, I suppose. Okay, you're getting a little too close for that. There we go. Oh, well, thank you for the compliment, Razor. You seem pretty cool, too. Thank you. Alright. Was I... yeah, reload. Yeah. Be fair. I've done a lot of work to become who I am today. And, what was I? Sorry, I'm just answering a message. I can imagine and read some of your profile. Oh, thanks. Yeah, I don't know what I was saying there. I lost my train of thought. All right. Well, examined a lot of my past actions, you know, talked to people who I wronged in the past, and, you know, asked them how I could be better, and put in the effort to actually be better. Done a lot of soul searching. And kept an open mind as far as changes go. The downside, though, is as much as I have improved as a person, my life in terms of work and, you know, getting out of the house has suffered. Can understand that. I was always the quiet person that no one really ever gave a second look at. Ow, yeah. The old me wasn't exactly quiet. I was obnoxious, an asshole, a bigot in a number of ways, but, I was very argumentative and aggressive back in the day. Then I got hit by a car at 16, and that was kind of the wake-up call. Though I ended up being more of a dick at first, because, you know, miserable. But, in the long run, it put me on a path to becoming a much better person. And so I'm thankful for it. You can relate to most of that? Yeah. It's nice to be able to look back at the people you used to be and go, you know, I'm not that person anymore. That person no longer exists. I'll admit, sometimes I miss the self-confidence of my old self. Worth the trade-off, though. Ah. That's true, yeah. Right. Well, what do I like about myself now? I don't think about that all that often, I guess. Well, I guess I do like that, like about myself that I, when it comes to something I like doing, like video games, for example, or, I don't know, being a history buff or a fan of philosophy, for example, moral philosophy especially, I like to be the best I can be. And keep improving. When it comes to video games, for example, like, that's why I play Wolfenstein on uber difficulty and Fear on extreme. I just like to challenge myself when it comes to stuff like that. And I'm also very self-analytical. I've gotten good at identifying where my flaws are and improving upon them. And like for me, it's that I can stand up for myself and not let anyone bother me anymore. Yeah, that's one I haven't really mastered yet. I'll fight when I get into an argument with someone nowadays, usually political, in all honesty. I'm very politically minded. But, when I get into arguments with people, usually people with horrible beliefs, I will fight back. I get extremely stressed out about it when I do, but I don't back down. And I do my research when I get into those kinds of arguments. I'll attach links, go into my reasoning, and I've been known to write entire essays in response to people. I can understand and respect that. I know what you mean, yeah. I still make mistakes sometimes that I'm not proud of, but, you know. Depending on the topic, you do pretty much the same, and kind of got like these kind of games when you have a discussion with people and try to show a point. Yeah. That's the kind of thing I can. What was I gonna say? That's all, folks. But yeah, I get that. When it comes to stuff like video games, discussion in regards to that,